23-6 on the season. NC State 16-13. Right now, here's Larry Dunlop with the starting lineups.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Greensboro and the Greensboro Coliseum Complex for the Atlantic Coast Conference Basketball Championship. The championship game features the North Carolina State Wolfpack and the Tar Heels of North Carolina. Now the starting lineups. For State, at forward, a 6'6 senior from Jacksonville, Florida, number 20, Jeremy Hyatt. Forward, a 6'6 senior from Great Falls, South Carolina, 00, Danny Strong. At guard, a 6'5 junior from Concord, North Carolina, number 5, Oshawa Benjamin. At guard, a 6-foot freshman from Greensboro, number 12, Justin Gainey. Guard, a 6'4 junior from Reidsville, North Carolina, number 23, C.C. Harrison. The head coach for State in his first year, Herb Sendak. And now the starters for the Tar Heels. At forward, a 6'8 sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina, number 33, Antawn Jamison. 6'8 sophomore from Berlin, Germany, number 13, Adamola Okalija. Carolina center, a 7'2 senior from Maasluis, the Netherlands, 45, Serge Zwicker. At guard, a 6'5 sophomore from Ormond Beach, Florida, number 15, Vince Carter. And at guard, a 6'2 junior from Greenville, South Carolina, number 3, Jamon Williams. Dean Smith is in his 36th year as head coach of the Tar Heels.
We will have the opening tip from the Greensboro Coliseum right after this. Throughout the tournament, they forced teams into turnovers. They protected the ball well, melted the clock, and made it count. Here's Benjamin, the way outside.
You see who was Mark Benjamin in the North Carolina man-to-man? It was Serge Zwicker.
This is Carter. Adams. Goes inside to Zwicker. 2-0 Tar Heels.
That was a great entry pass. You throw it up that high, nobody from North Carolina State's going to be able to get it.
And that's what you talked about in the pregame. That certainly is a tremendous mismatch for NC State.
It'll be interesting to see if NC State can utilize this mismatch, and that is Benjamin playing against Zwicker.
This is Harrison. He's had the hot hand throughout the tournament. Penetrates, shoots, and misses.
Benjamin is going to have to be able to score some from the perimeter to force North Carolina's Zwicker to come out, or some change in the North Carolina defensive alignment.
Elijah.
Boy, Elijah, what a great move in there. And again, Elijah is as big as anybody North Carolina State has on the court, so a tremendous size advantage for.
So Elijah makes it a 4-0 ball game, 18 and a half minutes to play first half. Don't forget now, NC State has fallen behind in every game in the tournament. Here's Benjamin, kicks it back to Hyatt. Jeremy Hyatt back to Benjamin. He'll fire from beyond the arc. And Okalaja.
Boy, that matchup problem that we talked about, Tim, it's been evident early. Hyatt matched up against
him. Here's Williams.
Well, you got to block out if you are the Wolfpack. But again, North Carolina with tremendous size and a tremendous offensive rebound.
Good spacing. Jamison's shot is short, and Hyatt comes up with it for NC State.
That was wasn't a classic block out by Danny Strong, but for Herb Sendek, Truson was good enough to get the ball, and that's all the better it has to be.
Working the ball around the perimeter. Again, Benjamin short with his shot off the front of the iron.
It's a tough pass. Super shooting over some 7 foot three.
Danny Strong with a big rebound. Great block out by NC State.
Now this is what North Carolina State wants to do. They want to walk the ball up the court, run some time off the clock.
Danny Strong on the baseline. Tough shot.
You know, it's interesting, Antawn Jamison has matched a pretty successful game.
Wicker with a pass inside to Jamison. Carter with the follow. Possession arrow belongs to the Wolfpack.
You lose Antawn Jamison inside. Well, North Carolina State did. Jamison simply misses the shot, and then Carter with an air ball from about 2 feet. Jeremy Hyatt battling very, very hard. It was ruled a jump ball. North Carolina State possession.
CC Harrison. And he's fouled. Shot will not count.
Tim, one of the things that North Carolina State has done extremely well against the man-to-man defense that they faced in the tournament is to really spread out the court. You can see nobody within the three-point arc in red shirts, but there's five white shirts right around the ball. Nice job by Harrison to draw the foul.
That was on Jamison. That's his first team foul for the Tar Heels. This is Danny Strong beyond the arc.
North Carolina in the zone that time after the out-of-bounds play.
1 point game with 16-10 to play first half. Here's Jamison, and he's fouled. Carolina's been successful getting it down deep, getting good shots, have not been able to finish. The foul is on Danny Strong. That's his first.
North Carolina State has done a great job defensively throughout the season, and in this tournament, they're holding their opponents to under 50 points a game.
Jamison, a 61% free throw shooter, was 3 for 5 yesterday and hits his first here. Two-time first-team all-conference player. Now Ed Cota comes into the ballgame, and Carter will go out. Ed Cota has gained so much confidence. Distributes well, breaks down defenses, protects the ball, leading vote-getter for Rookie of the Year. All rookie team in the conference. Six, three, North Carolina.
Now Zwicker is guarding Keene. This is an amazing match. The tallest guy on the court is guarding the littlest guy.
Ganey takes it all the way to the baseline, and Zwicker ends up with it.
And that's the problem. Zwicker can just envelop it.
Hyatt got his hand on it. Strong ends up with it. NC State playing good defense, getting their hands on a lot of balls.
This is really some matchup right here. Now you notice Zwicker playing way off. Zwicker's going to try basically to play zone, hanging in the middle of the lane.
Harrison hits a three.
North Carolina State has been forced into the perimeter game, and they've hit 2 3-point baskets for all 6 of their points.
We're tied at 6 as we approach the 15-minute mark, first half.
Strong and Zwicker really banging.
Shot clock down to 10. Here's Williams. Jamon Williams, who had 24 points yesterday, 4-7 beyond the arc, struggling there right now early on.
Obviously, with Zwicker guarding Ganey, North Carolina not going to put a lot of pressure on the ball when Ganey's got the ball. Harrison walks.
First turnover for NC State, 14-28 to play first half. We're tied at the Greensboro Coliseum.
And we talked about North Carolina and their size on the inside. You can see what they've been able to do over their last three games. Dominance in particular on the offensive boards today. They've doubled up the North Carolina State Wolfpack. And Serge Wicker, very important in terms of rebounding the basketball, but today he's the point center, guarding that point guard on defense.
Here's Wicker, banks it in.
NC State knocked that ball loose in there, but Zwicker active on the inside, good hands to catch it and lay it in. He's got four.
He was left all alone for the putback, and it's 8-6. Tar Heels.
Now notice how far Zwicker plays off Ganey. Ganey only a 23% three-point shooter.
He gets it right back.
Take that. But Zwicker can play off of him. Ganey is unlikely to shoot it over him. And if he tries to shoot it over him, Timmy's got to shoot it over a 7'2" guy. Then if Ganey penetrates to the basket, Zwicker, by just taking a couple of steps back, as long as he doesn't hand check him, he can get to the basket as quickly as Ganey and get those arms out there and make it tough to shoot a layup. Very interesting strategic move.
Again, NC State uses a lot of the clock. And a foul will be on Williams. He held CC Harrison as he cut through.
One of the problems with this defensive alignment is that with Zwicker playing out near the top, and there's a hold by Shimon Williams, he gets him on the shirt, but with Zwicker playing out near the top and Jamison trying to guard Danny Strong out of the three-point area, you don't have anybody in the middle.
A nice move by Jeremy Hyatt. And we're tied at 8. NC State playing with great confidence. Spreading the floor, get spacing, and making the offense work. Nice pass. Oh my, Jamison just came in the back door. Zwicker saw him.
Great hands once again by Zwicker. That ball bounced off Justin Ganey's head, and Zwicker grabbed it. North Carolina now in the zone.
Again, no panic at NC State as they work the perimeter.
NC State is very comfortable with a slowly paced game.
Hyatt again looked to penetrate and kicked it out to Benjamin, who had already moved.
Well, what Hyatt is telling Benjamin, hey, the object here is to penetrate inside the zone, and we got the penetration, the zone collapsed. If you'll stand there, you'll get a three. Two turnovers now for North Carolina State.
They look inside as Wicker. Instead, Dakota brings it back up top. Working against Ganey. Here's Coda. Nice pass to Jamison. And he's fouled.
And that's two fouls against Danny Strong. A little miscommunication on defense there by the Wolfpack. Strong thought he and Hyatt were going to switch, and they did not.
Great cut by Jamison back door, but how about the pass from Coda?
You can see that screen by Zwicker, though, is the key, and Strong at the end of that replay is telling Hyatt, hey, we were supposed to switch. Hyatt stayed with Zwicker. Nobody covering Jamison.
Fight for the rebound, and Hyatt gets it. It's 12-8 for North Carolina.
Even with two personal fouls, Strong stays in the game. Here's that zone again.
Here's Danny Strong.
And that's a basket. That's a shot that North Carolina State is going to have to make. Nice concept in the zone. Good screen by Benjamin. Got Strong open.
Most of the scoring in the tournament for NC State has come from Harrison and Strong. Again, the easy bucket by Jamison. He has 8. It's a 20-second timeout. 27 to play first half. It's 14-8 Carolina. Our call of the week from yesterday's Wake Forest North Carolina game. Take a look at the Tar Heels with the spread offense. Now watch Ed Cota. Makes a beautiful entry bounce pass to Antawn Jamison, who has position for the basket. It helps the Tar Heels to a 12-point lead with just under 4 minutes left. That was our call of the week, and Ed Cota has carried that in here today.
Danny Strong really having a tough time on the inside, and it's because Serge Zwicker setting screens in there. Zwicker actually uses Hyatt to help him with the screen. That gets Jamison open. North Carolina State said they were going to have a problem with that Zwicker-Jamison matchup. They've really had it thus far.
Harrison trying to take it to baseline. Now they get it back out to Ganey. Ganey hesitant with his shot. Here's Benjamin, gets into trouble.
That's the one they wanted, but they'll take it from Benjamin.
He has five, an impossible shot by Benjamin.
Those are the kind of shots that have been going in for North Carolina State in this tournament. The problem for the Wolfpack is that they're not only going to have to figure out how to score, but they've got to stop North Carolina. The Tar Heels, four of their last four.
This is Carter with the jumper.
Make it 5-5. North Carolina just isn't an interior team. You collapse everybody on the inside, and Carter, in particular, Shimon Williams can light you up from out there.
Jeremy Hyatt off the back of the iron, and there's Harrison with the rebound. North Carolina leads by six. Danny Strong has a good look again and misses. This foul's going to be called on Jai.
Jai and Hyatt got tangled up.
Makar Jai picks up his first personal. Another look, and we'll be back after this message from Budweiser. Today's game is being brought to you in part by Toyota. North Carolina State comes in as the number 8 seed, trying to become the first 8th seed to win a championship in the ACC tournament. Nowhere to go but up. How about this? The lowest seeds to win, 6th seed, happened 4 times. Now, I know you're going to dispute that.
No, the lowest seed to win. Actually, my point is that the lowest seed in the championship game isn't a number 8 seed. It was actually a number 7 seed, the University of Virginia in 1977. And how do you say is 7 lower than 8? Well, we've got 9 teams in the conference now. We only had 7 in 1977.
Trick question. Trick answer. Carolina leads by 6 with 10 minutes to play in the first half. This is Jeremy Hyatt back to Ganey.
And there's the zone again. Really has forced NC State almost exclusively to the perimeter.
It's an active zone, though. They extend it to the perimeter.
It's a big zone is what it is.
Here's Hyatt. And he had a good look and couldn't convert.
When you play a possession team like North Carolina State, you keep the pressure on most effectively by scoring when you have the ball.
Looking inside to get this Wicker.
Oh, what a great job not bringing the ball down, just turning and shooting it in the basket. He's got 6 now. And now, if you're North Carolina State, you're faced now with your largest deficit of the game. You've got to figure out a way to score, and North Carolina goes back to the man-to-man with Zwicker matched up against Ganey.
Carolina leads by 8. They double down on Strong. He kicks it out. Harrison shot off the iron.
He didn't really catch that one cleanly. And obviously only one shot opportunity per trip for North Carolina State.
In is Wicker again. And he banks it in. Serge Wicker had 17 points yesterday. He has 8 already here in the first half.
Jamison and Zwicker really screening for one another on the inside very effectively. They each have 8 points.
Misses his jumper.
If defensively you can force Ganey to shoot 3s, he's only a 23% shooter from out there. That's a big advantage.
On the baseline, Cota back to Williams. His jump shot. And Zwicker will be called for over the back.
Zwicker picks up the foul, but he has been a key factor in the game for Dean Smith's troops. Zwicker just big body, 7'2", Hyatt can't guard him, and as long as he doesn't bring the ball down, those 6'6 guys just aren't going to cause him any problem.
North Carolina on an 11-game win streak. A lot of reasons for that. So many people talk about the defense, and that has been a factor. North Carolina has really picked up offensively as well. Averaged 80 points over that 11-game win streak. And again, C.C. Harrison misses his shot. Here come the Tar Heels.
Seems like every shot they take, they're shooting it over Zwicker.
Jump hook by Zwicker. Jamison.
What rebound.
And Strong ends up with it. Wolfpack down by 10. How many times has the Wolfpack been on the ropes in this tournament? Ganey's got that shot. He's got to pull the trigger on top.
Tim, one of the things that North Carolina State has done most effectively is use their personnel doing the things they can do, and Ganey just isn't a great outside shooter.
Williams picks up his second personal with 7:06 to play in the first half. It's a 10-point lead. We'll be back after this. For Carp, how many times have been on the ropes? Well, NC State was down 21-5 to Duke, and yet they're getting the shots here, Dan, but they aren't putting them down.
They're not getting the kinds of shots that they've been getting in the prior games in the tournament. They're basically standstill shooters. They're standstill jump shots, mostly beyond the three-point line, and unfortunately for the Wolfpack, they're only 2 of 10 from beyond the line. They've missed their last 6 shots.
Jamison and Zwicker have been big inside. That's been the mismatch, and they are making it count.
We talked about that before the game. What does North Carolina State do with Jamison and Zwicker? And they haven't really solved the problem. Each man playing very effectively on the inside.
You mentioned that Zwicker sagging so deeply on Ganey. He's got that shot outside, but he's been reluctant to pull the trigger.
Coming into this game, Ganey only 9 for 40 from beyond the three-point arc. So that's not his game, shooting the ball out there. North Carolina back to the zone.
Zwicker getting a breather, Jai in the middle. Still a big body, big presence. Here's Ganey Strong, and he hits the 3.
The 3 can be the great equalizer in a game like this, and North Carolina State now 3 for 11. Those are Strong's first points of the game.
That cuts the Carolina lead to 7. Boy, they're banging inside. Carter can't handle the entry pass. That's 4 turnovers for North Carolina now.
North Carolina continues, though, Tim, to do a great job screening on the inside, forcing North Carolina State to make some decisions about whether to switch or not to switch. And Carter had position, but as you correctly stated, just couldn't handle the pass.
Jeremy Hyatt. Hyatt misses the jumper. The Tar Heels run. Williams pushes it down. Tried to get it inside to Jamison. Here's Carter banking it in, but he walked first. 5 turnovers for North Carolina. And NC State gets a break.
Tim, one of the things that NC State has done pretty well early in the game is keep pretty good pressure on the ball. We mentioned Antawn Jamison has 8 points in the game, but he's been open a lot on the inside. North Carolina hasn't been able to see him all the time. Of course, they've seen him enough to get 8 points.
So all the turnovers that we were talking about, 5 for Carolina.
Got to the man-to-man.
Good penetration and the finish by Harrison. That now has 5.
That's what North Carolina State has done most effectively in this tournament on offense, is get the penetration and score as a result of the penetration.
NC State has cut the lead to 5.
Ganey trying to keep that pressure on the ball.
Back out to Okalaja, looks over to Carter. He checks the shot clock at 10 and goes with it and fires up an air ball.
That was real good defense. Oshawa Benjamin moved his body very effectively, didn't jump up and try to block the shot, but bothered it sufficiently that Carter missed it.
NC State trying to make one of those runs that have kept him in every ball game in this tournament. Strong again. Not even close this time, but look at Harrison. Couldn't convert.
Strong just picked up his 3rd foul.
Away from the basketball.
I was going after the offensive rebound. CeCe Harrison with a very acrobatic rebound, just not able to get it back up and get it in the basket.
Nobody blocks Harrison out. Okalaja tries at the last minute, but not able to do it. Harrison didn't really collect. He wasn't able to collect himself on balance. So Strong comes over the back, picks up the third foul.
Luke Buffum comes into the ballgame. He made two critical free throws yesterday against Maryland. And Danny Strong sits down on the NC State bench.
Up again.
Now I can understand that on the other end, but that's a little crazy. Ganey being the pitched up against Whitner on the defensive end.
Cota recognized it, tried to get it in as Whitner threw the pass too low, and Ganey knocked it out of bounds.
That's right. When you see that mismatch, you throw the ball 9 feet high. You don't throw it 4 feet high.
Carter. Jamison with the follow. Left alone underneath. He now has 10 points.
Seven rebounds to go along with those 10 points. They weren't trying to leave him alone. Benjamin was trying to block him out, but Benjamin did Jamison.
Under 4 minutes to play in the first half. They're going to call a foul on Carter. Carter for the foul. He was called for the hold. That'll be his first. Carolina leads by 7. NC State hanging around. We'll be back after this message from Bell South.
2-15, and if you're going to try to rebound with North Carolina, you better expect some physical play. I think we said that Jamison shed Benjamin. I think that's one way to describe it. Jamison getting position for that offensive rebound.
3:51 to play in the first half, 22-15 Carolina.
And with Danny Strong going out of the game with foul problems, that creates further mismatch problems for North Carolina State. They move Buffum on Zwicker. They're now trying to guard Jamison with Benjamin. The rebounding North Carolina with an 8 rebound advantage. And actually North Carolina State has done well on the defensive boards. North Carolina really dominating inside. In fact, 20 of the 22 Tar Heel points have come from front court players.
Jamison with 10, Zwicker with 8. Keep in mind, North Carolina's averaged over 80 points over the last 7 games. Here's Harrison, that's for 3. And just like that, it's 22-18. Harrison with 8 points. This is Ganey on Cota.
Benjamin almost got that one.
Nice jump stop by Williams in the short jumper. His first basket.
Man-to-man for North Carolina. Zwicker with the more conventional matchup against Buffalo now.
Benjamin shoots from 3.
You know, Tim, North Carolina State has not gotten bad shots. They've gotten some good open looks at the basket. They simply have not been able to get them to go down.
Buffum got in the way and picked up his first.
Lots of times when you're playing against North Carolina, that's the best you can do with those big guys inside is get in the way.
During North Carolina's 11-game win streak, the Tar Heels have shot 78% at the free throw line. See Williams' tournament average, almost 19 points a game. He hits the free throw, now has 3 points.
Tim, during that run, they're scoring a lot of points. So when you score a lot of points, that makes it difficult for the opposition. They've got to match you if they're going to stay in the game.
He makes them both. It's 26-18 North Carolina.
And keep in mind, Tim, this is a North Carolina State team that only averages 59 points a game.
Dan, I'm reminded now's a great time to order Pizza Hut's new pepperoni pizza. Pizza Hut making it great again and again.
You know, you're reminded of that every game.
Benjamin kicks it out to Buffum. He's going to fire from out there and hit it. Luke Buffum.
That is the first field goal in this tournament for North Carolina State by somebody other than a starter. Buffer had two free throws yesterday. So now North Carolina State's bench has 4 points in this tournament.
Buffum listed as a high school product out of Beverly Hills, California, but actually grew up in Burlington, North Carolina. Ball's loose, possession arrow is going to belong to the Tar Heels.
This was one that North Carolina State almost got. Pretty good defense on the ball. Harrison doing a nice job, gets his hands on it, just goes right past Benjamin. Benjamin was headed the other way before he got the ball. And as a result, the Tar Heels keep it, but there remains only 13 seconds on the shot clock. Nice screen inside by Okalaja.
Down to 10 on the shot clock. Here's Kota, 5 on the shot clock. We pass it along the baseline and lose it, turn it over. And with a 6-point lead, 1:54 to go in the first half, NC State's going to get it back and try to draw a little bit closer.
North Carolina State, solid defensive effort throughout the tournament. They're an excellent defensive team, number one in scoring defense in the country, and they've showed us why all weekend.
Wolfpack just hanging around. Hyatt has a look, gets it over to Ganey. Eight on the shot clock. Nice pass by Benjamin to Harrison. How about that?
Tim Benjamin dribbled around, mesmerized the North Carolina defense, and Harrison snuck in behind.
Harrison now has 10 points. It's a 4-point game. Gets the roll. His first bucket.
Continue to be impressed with the number of offensive weapons North Carolina can bring to bear. What's that all about?
40 seconds to play in the half. Harrison on the baseline again. Benjamin almost has it picked off. Shot clock down to 5. He didn't have to shoot that quickly, but Buffum gets it back, and he's fouled. Fouled by Jamison.
That's a heck of a break for North Carolina State. He was fouled just before the shot clock ran out. That ball never hit the rim.
The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Raycom and Jefferson Pilot Sports. Any use of this broadcast without their express permission is prohibited.
I think these are big free throws, Tim.
Buffum now 3 for 3 in the tournament at the line.
And he makes them both. It's a 4-point game.
He's 6 for 12 in the year. And rolls the second one in. 28-24.
Carolina State showing a little zone.
Shot clock is off. Game clock at 10 seconds. Inside to Jamison, and he's fouled by Buffum.
What great ball movement by North Carolina, and Jamison moves so well without the ball. Just pops open on the inside. What a great pass through the zone. Good hands by Jamison to collect it. That foul on Hyatt.
That'll be the first on Hyatt. Jamison goes to the line.
Boy, and that's a back break.
Okalazi gets it back. First half at the Greensboro Coliseum. Could Cinderella be dressed in red? Carolina hopes not. And the Tar Heels lead 30-24. 24. We'll have the halftime activities for you with Steve Martin when we come back. ACC side with State still alive.
North Carolina State has done what they needed to do to stay in the game, but if they're going to win the game, they've got to figure out a way to shut off that inside attack for North Carolina, and they've got to get Danny Strong and Jeremy Hyatt involved in it offensively. Now, as we talk about North Carolina's inside attack, we're talking about Jamison and Zwicker. They've worked very well together. There's Zwicker with the screen, gets rid of both Hyatt and Strong, and that frees Jamison up inside. Then, with some penetration, Hyatt steps over to help out, leaves Zwicker, and you can't leave Zwicker that close to the basket, and he catches it and knocks it in. C.C. Harrison, what a great tournament he's had, and he continues to produce. He had 2 3-point baskets in the first half, 10 points. North Carolina State within striking distance. They need to really do some executing to stay in it.
Jamison and Zwicker with 20 of North Carolina's 30 points. Take a look at the Weyerhaeuser halftime statistics, and 0 for 4 beyond the arc for North Carolina. Rebounds, North Carolina has the advantage there.
North Carolina hasn't scored from beyond the 3-point arc, but they're doing a great job on the inside, outscoring North Carolina State significantly on the inside. That's where they have the big advantage. That's where they've been going, and they've been successful.
I have to believe that the coaches reminded everybody on that Tar Heel team that this is the exact same spot that three other teams were in earlier in this tournament.
Well, I think North Carolina State team has played well enough that they've got everybody's attention, and I know they have the Tar Heels' attention.
All right, we'll be back with the second half of the ACC Championship from the Greensboro Coliseum.
By Pizza Hut. By Ford. By Nationwide Insurance.
North Carolina leading NC State 30-24 as we prepare to start the second half. And Dan, what about the game plan? What has to happen here?
North Carolina State has done a good job staying in the game, but if they're going to produce in the game, they've got to have that second half explosion. They've averaged 42 points per second half throughout this ACC tournament. They've got to produce that way again. And for North Carolina, they've attacked very well on the offensive end. They're getting it done on the inside. And I think for the Tar Heels, you just have to maintain your attack, particularly on the inside.
Dan, you can't walk in this building or any building that houses the NC or the ACC tournament without going up to Skeeter Francis and taking a look at it. There he is, a luminary. Skeeter Francis, tournament director, 1969 to 1989.
And Skeeter Francis, a very interesting jacket. Skeeter, not quite so colorful. Got a different one. So Skeeter, he's been demoted. He's not the tournament director. He's now our timeout coordinator. But Skeeter was the tournament director, as you mentioned, from 69 to 89. He was around, I think, at the formation of the Southern Conference before the ACC. In fact, I think the Paleolithic Age.
How about the haircut on Phil Ford? Of course, that was the style back then.
We talked about North Carolina State and their big three being Harrison, Hyatt, and Strong, and how North Carolina had to solve problems there. They have done so. North Carolina State, on the other hand, Jamison and Zwicker producing 20 points between them. That's something that the Wolfpack will have to improve in the second half.
All right, the final 20 minutes of the ACC Tournament Championship game. NC State has it first, man-to-man defense by North Carolina.
Zwicker playing far off of Gainey.
This is Benjamin.
Boy, again, another good look at the basket. North Carolina State just doesn't get it to go down.
Williams pushes it in a hurry and fires from the baseline and hits it.
And that's something that North Carolina State can ill afford, is to come out and have North Carolina State throw one of those, or North Carolina throw one of those patented 6 to 10 point runs at them. That will have to change the entire complexion of the game.
32-24, Carolina. Here's Harrison.
Nice job by Carter.
Jeremy Hyatt for three.
That's a big basket.
He now has 5 points.
North Carolina State attempted more threes than twos in the first half. And I just think that's the way the game's going to go. They're going to have to convert some.
Double down on Jamison, over to Zwicker, and he'll take the jump shot from there.
What a nice catch and shoot.
Now Zwicker in double figures. He has 10 today. Had 17 yesterday, including a three-pointer at the end of the game.
See if North Carolina State tries to use Ganey as a screen.
Strong misses his three. Harrison loses it out of bounds. It'll belong to the Tar Heels. Dan Strong has had some wide open three attempts.
Tim, and you asked the question before the game about the 4 games in 4 days, and I said I thought it could be done, and I still do. Williams drills that one. Boy, if he's going to get...
Look out.
It's going to be tough mistake.
Boy, you're right. When he gets hot, it's trouble.
But it's very possible, you know, shooting has an awful lot to do with your legs, and it's very possible that these guys are playing on some tired legs, and that may make a difference.
Hyatt takes it right down the middle.
A tough shot.
I see Williams start to get that feel, Dan. I think back to that Duke game last year where he hit 6 of 8 from beyond the arc.
North Carolina State is not looking to push the basketball. They want to get it set up. As I said, in this situation, Ganey might want to try to act as a screener to force Zwicker to do something to just stand in the middle of the lane.
With Benjamin with a layup. Nicely done.
That's two acrobatic shots by Benjamin. If you were playing him in horse, you'd have H.O. and you'd be struggling.
This foul's going to be called on Benjamin, the hand check out front. That'll be the first team foul against NC State.
Zwicker, you'll notice, ignoring Ganey entirely, coming down to help, so Benjamin's got to beat two guys, not only Cota, but also Zwicker, does it effectively, protecting the ball with the rim so Zwicker can't get it.
Ed Cota checks in. Jamison gets a breather here. 16:55 to play in the ball game. Nice pass. Good idea for execution. Here comes Harrison at the other end with a pull-up jumper.
And that's a shot that has to go. If you're going to take it that quickly in North Carolina State's offensive concept, it has to go into that.
It's still a 7-point North Carolina lead. Here's Carter. Offensive.
Carter's struggling a little bit offensively. He has 2 fouls now. He lost that last pass on the inside. And this one, he gets called for the charge. Watch as he lowers that shoulder right there. That is the signal for the official to put that hand behind the head.
Teammates helped him up, Dan, and he said, "My fault, fellas, my fault. Shot too quickly."
North Carolina State with only 2 turnovers, but they have not been able to get the ball to go down on their shooting, so...
Interesting. Harrison takes that charge, still thinking of his last offensive trip, telling the guys, "My fault." Here's Oshawa Benjamin from beyond the arc. 3 more for NC State.
Nice ball movement that time.
Benjamin now in double figures. He has 10 points. The average is 9.
An important note about those turnovers for North Carolina State. North Carolina obviously not applying defensive pressure, and now the ball gets thrown away. 9 turnovers for the Tar Heels.
Okalazu never had a chance. Could not get to it. 36-32 Tar Heels. We'll be back after this message from Budweiser. Has won 13 ACC tournament titles. NC State has won 10, and 2 of them belong to Jimmy Valvano. Some of the fans reminding the players here on this team, never give up. 36-32, North Carolina, 15:43 to play.
North Carolina State continues to spread the floor.
Ganey looks up and checks the shot clock. 15 seconds there. He fires from the outside. That's for 2.
And that's a nice job by Ganey. Just taking a couple of dribbles. Wicker backs up. Nice, comfortable 2-point shot. That's in Ganey's range.
His first basket of the afternoon. It's 36-34.
Wicker looking for the ball inside. Again, good ball pressure by North Carolina State prevents the easy entry pass.
Cota penetrates and loses it. Benjamin picks it up.
It's that Ganey fella again. He knocked it away from Cota.
He's had a great tournament, too. He has not been out of this a ball game for 1 second in this tournament.
He has played with the boys of the senior. Jeremy Hyatt, offensive foul, out of control on the baseline. Solid defense by Okolaja.
Hyatt saw an opportunity. Hyatt did a nice job yesterday getting to the basket against Rodney Elliott and Obina Akizi, two bigger guys from Maryland. He thought he had a shot there against Okolaja, but wasn't able to complete it.
And there's another one of those guys that does so much for this ball club, Okolaja. He has really had a nice season. One of the leaders in rebounding, three-point shooter, skill leader. And here's three more. He now has 11. Williams is feeling it.
You can get point production from Williams on the outside and Carter on the outside. Carter not in the game at the moment, but when you get production from the outside, it really loosens things up in the middle.
Gainey again.
Now that's a three. As we mentioned, he's not a good three-point shooter.
Williams.
Yes! I'm telling you, that is right in the face of one of the best defenders in the league.
He's feeling it. He now has 14.
And now North Carolina State, Tim, is in a position where they've got to respond offensively.
Jamon Williams with 10 points this half at 42-34. Benjamin short on his jumper.
Job by Deaney, a good screen. We talked about maybe that he would be valuable as a screener with Zwicker guarding him. Got an open shot that time. Man to man for the Wolfpack.
You can just see Jamon Williams wants the fire. Works off
here
his jump
and lets it go.
Three more for Williams.
You talk about concentrating on the inside. Nice screens by those inside guys. The first time Zwicker sets the screen, he gets them open. That time, just a good move off the dribble, and he gets himself open. And now Jamison and Okolaja with two screens, and he's open. North Carolina has scored 15 points in the second half, and Williams has 13 of them, including all three North Carolina three-point field goals.
Heels are playing so well. And once again, NC State on the ropes.
North Carolina runs out to their largest lead, Tim, and that's what we're talking about. North Carolina with a lot of offensive weapons, doing it on the inside of the first half, and now recognizing the hot hand and going to Jamon Williams in the second.
North Carolina playing for a number one seed in the NCAA tournament. NC State playing just to get in. Hyatt for three for State.
Big basket, North Carolina in the zone that time. North Carolina State now has to turn it over to its defense, Tim. They need some defensive stops.
11 and a half minutes to play. Inside is Wicker. Wicker couldn't get it to go down.
Nice rebound by Strong. Williams out of the game for a breather. Even all those threes wears you out. And he's out of the game for a breather, and right away North Carolina goes back to the inside game.
Harrison underneath.
Oh, wow, what a
shot. And couldn't get the tip back.
That was good defense by North Carolina. They forced a very difficult shot without fouling.
We're now going to 11 minutes of the championship game. 45-37, Tar Heels. Jamison wanted the ball. Strong gets it back. It was intended for Jamison.
They were too late. First time Jamison was open, they didn't find it. They cannot continue to come down and have empty trips, Tim.
This is Gainey. Yes.
He's pretty good. He steps inside that three-point line. He's now got 4 points.
Pulls the Carolina lead back to six. Boy, every time you think they're putting NC State away, they just fight back. Here's a walk by Galazza. That's 13 turnovers now for North Carolina. Martin. 10:02 to play. North Carolina 45. NC State 39. We'll be back. Intensity now is lifted to a championship level with 10:02 to play. North Carolina leads NC State 45-39 in a full house in the Greensboro Coliseum. More than 23,000 here today. 23,297 to be exact. And they have been treated to some great stories in this 44th annual ACC tournament. NC State certainly the lead story. The Cinderella team, we've read fate, destiny. Could they do it again?
North Carolina applying some pressure really for the first time. Tim, I don't know that the story, the fairy tale we're talking about here is Cinderella. I think it's more like the brave little tailor. These guys are trying to go out and slay a pretty big giant.
Thought it was interesting yesterday, Maryland coach Gary Williams said, hey, that's not a bad club we lost to. Don't think we were terribly upset. This is a very good basketball team, a different team than we saw earlier in the year.
Shot clock running down.
Strong has a look and buries a three. Splash, 45-42.
Every time you think they're dead, they come back. Williams back in the game. We'll see if he remains.
Possession arrow belongs to North Carolina.
My goodness, what a tournament that young man has had.
Five on the shot clock.
Dakota has taken this ball hard to the basket. Gainey gets up. I mean, no body contact there. He can't do it any better than that. Now, can they hold it?
Martin puts it on the ground, and Benjamin takes it away.
Benjamin settles it down. North Carolina gets back on defense well, but they could actually tie the game with a three. Herb Sendex group 7 of 20 from three-point range. I had never saw Benjamin coming by.
Harrison has a look. Gets it back to Benjamin. 10 on the shot clock. Harrison recognizes it. Kicks it out to Hyatt. He's left alone. Could not get it to go down.
Now let's see if North Carolina can apply another punch to send it to the canvas, Tim. That's what Carolina has done in this tournament.
Gainey with the steal. Benjamin looking for help.
Jeremy Hyatt called a timeout.
Smart play by Hyatt. Now he wants a 20-second timeout, but he saw that Benjamin was in trouble. Could not find an outlet, and with 7:55 to play, calls the timeout. NC State trailing by three. The Nation's Bank, a corporate partner of the Atlantic Coast Conference, presents this ACC Salute to Excellence question. Only two first-year coaches have won the ACC tournament. Who are they? Coming up shortly.
Tim, it's very interesting. We talked about North Carolina State needing to solve the problem of North Carolina hammering them on the inside. You can see North Carolina, most of their points coming on the inside in the first half, but with Shamon Williams heating up from three-point range, it's been the outside in the second half.
Hyatt gets it over to Gaines. Back to Hyatt as they work the perimeter. Hyatt again draws iron off the front of the hoop.
They had two opportunities, two threes to tie the game and missed them both.
Both times it was Hyatt. And here's Benjamin with a steal. It's a two-on-one.
Oh, marvelous defense by Coda.
Great hands by the freshman. Knocks it out of bounds. And with 7:29 left in the game, there's timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. It's 45-42 Tar Heels. How about this defense by the freshman? Won the ACC tournament. Who are they? The answer is, from the Dan Bonner archives, Vic Bubas and Press Maravich.
Now, Herb Sendek, of course, could become only the second coach to win the title in his actual first year in the ACC tournament. Press Maravich, that was his first year at North Carolina State, but he had coached with Clemson in the tournament before that.
What a job he's done. Wolfpack beat Georgia Tech, beat Duke, beat Maryland. And now trying to do the same to North Carolina.
Doing a great job forcing turnovers and converting them. North Carolina's turned the ball over 10 times in the second half.
Paul Strong had a look, gets it back to Gainey. Inside they go and back out again.
He's had two opportunities to pull a little closer.
Shot clock down to 12.
Zone defense.
Benjamin recognizes it. Strong fires.
Where they had three-point shots, open looks at the basket to tie the game. They missed all three. North Carolina's not going to give you very many more chances.
Under 7 minutes to play. Does Wicker, yes. Serge Wicker now with 12 points. 47-42. Little amount of points they scored in the last meeting between these two in Raleigh.
Carolina stays in the zone.
Gainey.
Finally gets the three.
47-45, Carolina. So many young players taking big roles. Here's Jamison inside, fouled by Hyatt.
Tim, in the last couple of possessions looked like the first half for North Carolina. Wicker and Jamison screening for one another. A couple of times in the first half, we saw miscommunication between Hyatt and Strong on the screen. Again, Hyatt doesn't switch. Strong is telling him right now, hey, you got to switch that screen. Shamon Williams, who hit some big threes earlier in the half, sets up the three-point play here by Antawn Jamison.
Now Jamison gets the roll and makes it a 50-45 ball game. Jeremy Hyatt has picked up his third personal.
And now North Carolina goes back to the man-to-man.
And we've got 6 minutes to play in the championship game. Harrison looks at Okolaja, measures his options, and fires from out there. Benjamin got up there, got his hands on it, couldn't hold it. Jumped in his face.
Well, it's interesting. C.C. Harrison hasn't scored in this half. He had 10 at halftime, still has 10.
Williams stumbled. Cody got it back. Shot clock now down to 14. Down to 7. Inside to go to Jamison. How about the entry pass?
What an acrobatic catch and shot.
And Jamison has 17 points.
Just like that, it's back to 7.
Benjamin with the penetration, banks it in.
Tough shot.
Great strong drive by Oshawa Benjamin. 5-point deficit for NC State. The entry pass to Jamison. Hyatt was there. Williams gets a look for the baseline.
But Hyatt doing everything you can do to prevent Jamison from scoring on that play.
Again, it's amazing to me These five players have gone almost every minute of this tournament. Four games. And apparently haven't hit the wall yet. Strong shot is short. Harrison came down on Williams' back
and rode there for a minute or two.
Strong, really struggling with that jump shot.
Time now becomes a factor as we go under 4 minutes.
Well, if you're the North Carolina State Wolfpack, you've just got to suck it up and play right now. North Carolina going to spread the court, try to run some time off the clock, apply a little NC State strategy.
First step by Williams.
Shot.
What a first step to gain the advantage. He has 19 points.
State has responded all weekend. Do they have another response?
Oh, Ganey, dangerous pass. Tried to get it to Strong. Almost threw it away. Benjamin left alone. Really good offense. Got him a wide open shot. That one looked like it just slid out of the hands of Oshawa Benjamin. Say what you will about NC State continuing to come back. Ganey inside is fouled. But Carolina continues to hold him off as well. This foul on Ed Cota.
Ganey makes a big, big play. Ganey looks like a tired young fellow to me right now, Tim.
I think their last three shots from the outside have looked like two. Just don't have the legs.
Ganey's at the line trying to catch his breath. Look at that.
He's a 62% free throw shooter. Makes the first one. He has 8 points. He's now made 32 of his 51 free throws this year. He's had a terrific tournament. The freshman for sure, the boys of the senior. And missing the second. Carolina by six with 2:50 to play.
Sendek trying to motivate his kids for one last big effort.
Benjamin on Williams. Williams now calls the attack. 15 seconds on the shot clock. Down to eight. Here's Williams. Strong gets it back. The outlet pass to Benjamin. State will get it back. Sendek wanted a foul call. Carolina wanted the ball back. We have 2 minutes and 15 seconds to play. It's 54-48. North Carolina will be back after this from Budweiser. You see the time remaining in the championship game from Greensboro. North Carolina leading 54-48.
North Carolina State with possession of the basketball. With only 2 minutes and 15 seconds left, they are in a situation where they have to score. The last couple of trips, North Carolina has tried to milk the clock. They've run it all the way down. They haven't been able to convert it at the end of the shot clock, Tim. But if North Carolina State can't take advantage by scoring, then that works in the Tar Heels' favor.
Dan, take a look at our Advance Auto Parts game summary.
North Carolina State forcing those 17 turnovers. They've done a nice job converting those into baskets. But North Carolina, the big edge on the board, and Shamon Williams, 15 second-half points, has really helped the Tar Heels hold off the North Carolina State charge to this point.
Carolina closed the regular season with 9 straight wins. 2 more here in the tournament. Unquestionably one of the hottest teams in the country. Playing well, trying to hold on to win the ACC championship. 54-48 Tar Heels with 2:13 to play.
Now, North Carolina State does not have a great deal of time to play around with the ball. North Carolina in their zone, trying to force them to run some time off the clock before they shoot.
Strong gets another good look. He just cannot get his threes to go down. Here he is again. And again he's short. Zwicker walked. Turnover Carolina. with 1:46 to play. That's 18 turnovers for the Tar Heels this afternoon.
They really, really need to get a basket.
Shot clock resets at 35. But it's the game clock that has become so important for the NC State Wolfpack now. Harrison still has not scored in this half. Here he is. It has it blocked.
And that may be enough right there.
Nice pass to Okaliza, and he's fouled by Harrison.
Boy, Herb Sendek has seen his team play hard for four consecutive games. Just not able to get those. They had a couple of shots at it. Some concern on the Wolfpack bench. North Carolina, I'm feeling a little bit more comfortable right now. Defensive stand turned into a transition opportunity. North Carolina State missing its last seven shots.
Okaliza makes the first one. NC State may have just hit that wall. What a year it's been for North Carolina. The football team finished 10th in the country. Women's basketball team has been in the top 10. Men's basketball team in the top 10. First time that's ever happened to a school in the AP top 10 rankings. All three of those teams. Foul by Gainion Williams.
We talked about the North Carolina advantage in size, and you've seen it at various points in the ballgame. None more evident than right there as Wicker just keeps the ball alive, and finally North Carolina retains possession. That's only team foul number 5 against North Carolina State, so there'll be no shots. Dean Smith calls a 20-second timeout. Talk about how they want to inbound the ball and who he wants to handle the ball coming down the stretch. You'd obviously like to keep it in the hands of your most productive free throw shooters.
Play 55-48 North Carolina, still a three possession ball game, but time running out on the Wolfpack.
It's a three possession ball game, and what North Carolina is going to try to do is run as much time off the clock as they can before they shoot the basketball. North Carolina State doesn't, as you say, it's a three possession game. They don't have time to let North Carolina run time off the clock. If they don't get the steal on the inbound pass, they're going to have to try to get the early foul.
Here's Gainey fouls Wicker. Interesting, it's been the game plan throughout the tournament for NC State to melt the clock, and here now they've got to utilize every second.
Wicker has had a very fine tournament for North Carolina and a very fine year as well. He's actually a 75% free throw shooter.
That was the last foul to give. One more, they're over the limit, and Carolina will be shooting 1-1.
Oh, nice ball movement.
Here at Dakota, and he's fouled by Hyatt. 1:14 to play.
Good offense foul out there on the court right now.
Dakota will go to the line shooting 1-1. Ed Coda, the freshman from Brooklyn, New York, 73% free throw shooter. He was 4-for-4 at the line yesterday.
Nice job by North Carolina to move the ball and run a few seconds off the clock before the Wolfpack able to get the foul.
This is the first one. Smith Carter gets the rebound.
Short is a tough one to rebound if you're the team with inside position where North Carolina State was, but Swicker tipped it back again.
As soon as Carter touched it, Gainey fouled him. 1:11 to play now. Coda goes out of the ballgame, and Okaliza comes back in. So now Vince Carter goes to the line. He's a 74% free throw shooter, and he was 2-for-2 at the line yesterday.
Danny's drunk. Blocked Serge Wicker out to about half court. He wasn't having Wicker touching that one again.
What a story Vince Carter has been after a disappointing freshman year, sometimes frustrating. Being injured early this season, he has come back and played very well and been a key in the Carolina surge.
Well, Tim, interesting in this game, North Carolina's got 4 fouls to give if they want to.
Harrison for 3. 1:03 to play. It's 56-51. Harrison's first bucket of the second half.
And obviously North Carolina, Tim, is not going to just go out and foul, but it's going to make it difficult. If North Carolina State is trying to handle the ball, they can play pretty aggressively. Doesn't care if they foul.
We'll be back after this message from the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Carolina State has one timeout left. It's a full timeout. North Carolina, with its complement of two full timeouts and a 20-second timeout remaining. We mentioned only two team fouls against the Tar Heels here in the second half. So they've got four fouls to give. If North Carolina State gets the ball back, then North Carolina can afford to play very aggressively on defense, forcing North Carolina State to run some time off the clock and foul them and make them take the ball out of bounds. That could be a very disruptive tactic. But for the Wolfpack, they need to get the ball back. And if they don't get a steal, they don't have a lot of time to play around. If they don't get a steal, they're going to have to foul immediately.
Jeremy Hyatt goes out of the ball game. Luke Buffum comes in for NC State. 103 to play. With Elijah, he's fouled immediately by Benjamin.
Benjamin took the brunt of it.
Benjamin got his money's worth.
Now Hyatt will check back in as Herb Sendek works offense defense strategy. That's the ninth team foul against NC State, so they're still shooting 1-1. Okolaja at the line.
He's the guy they wanted to get.
Right, he's a 53% free throw shooter. He's at 29 of his 55 attempts. Ice. 57-51, Tar Heels. Coliseum just made it a three-possession game again. As we go under the 1 minute mark.
Can he commit a foul in the act of shooting?
Can he foul and one?
Boy, you know, he didn't need for him to foul it in the act of shooting.
The foul is on Ed Cota, the freshman.
Cota was looking to commit the foul out about half court, and Ganey just went right by him. Boy, Ganey continues to play a solid game. 10 points now. You see Shimon Williams there in the background with his hands on his head. He knew that that's not what they wanted to do.
Ganey has played every second of this tournament. He has not come out of a game yet. Ganey will be at the line. He's a 62% free throw shooter.
Now, Dean Smith has just called a 20-second timeout that he wants to get this business about fouls to give and when you're going to foul and that kind of stuff totally squared away. Going to draw up a diagram. He's going to diagram what he wants them to do to get the ball in bounds, or simply to remind them what play they want to run. But for North Carolina, what you have to do right now, you've got to get the ball in bounds and you've got to make free throws. And as long as you play intelligently on the defensive end, you can't lose the game.
Dean Smith chasing Rupp's record. Smith has 874 wins at Carolina. He also has 12 ACC tournament titles. Pressure on the freshman.
We got one shot here. Wait for the release.
57 seconds left, trailing by five. Carolina. Williams splits the double team and is fouled. The foul is on Ganey. North Carolina's 9 of 14 at the line as Ganey picks up his fourth personal. Williams now will make a trip to the charity stripe. Buffum goes back out of the game as Hyatt comes back in.
It's a good play by Okolaja to get rid of the basketball. Of course, he just made the two free throws. But he got the ball to a better free throw.
I was just going to say, you go from a 53% free throw shooter to a guy who shoots better than 80% at the line.
Two shots. We're over the 10 foul limit. Well, Williams just really had a big second half.
And he's confident. He just smiles and looks over and shakes his head. Nothing to it. Yesterday, he has 21 here this afternoon. 52 seconds left in Carter foul.
Now that's where you want to get the foul, and that's what Dean Smith wanted him to do the last time.
That's the 14th foul against the Tar Heels.
We still have two more to give.
51.6 seconds left.
one more to give. It's battle against time.
Only 1 second went off.
It's four fouls from Carter. Carter's going to want to give any more.
I thought he was going to let him bring it across and get a little more time off the clock. Here's Harrison down the lane, and he's fouled by Carter. The bucket won't count.
There we go.
That'll be five on Vince Carter. He'll be disqualified.
I don't think Carter was trying to give a foul in that situation.
No, absolutely not.
Harrison just beat him to the basket.
Carter actually, like a swinging gate, tried to get out of the way. So Carter will leave with five personals, and Serge Zwicker will come back into the ballgame. Zwicker has 12 points. Eight of those came in the first half.
Now, Dean Smith taking a long time to get Zwicker in the game. He's got 30 seconds to do it, but that gives North Carolina State the time to talk things over.
Carolina has no more fouls to give. 46.7 seconds left.
It goes to show you how versatile the Tar Heels are offensively. Carter only 3 points today.
NC State needs a couple of threes. Hyatt. And the immediate foul. That could do it. 39.3 seconds left. North Carolina going after its 14th ACC Tournament title. Boy, as many times as NC State made a run at them, they just not would relinquish the lead.
Damon Thornton, of course, on the North Carolina State bench. That hip problem, he has not played at all. It's a very fine ACC Tournament run by his teammates.
Zwicker, 13 points. Rebounds, and Carolina's just been so tough at the free throw line. 62-54, Carolina. Harrison has it blocked. That'll do it. Benjamin with the immediate foul. But NC State is running out of time, and Carolina trying to get a number one seed in the NCAA tournament.
Confident at this point in the game, as well they should, and now they can start looking forward to next weekend. And I agree with you, Tim. I think they will be a number one seed in the NCAA tournament,
and a team that will be tough to beat.
A team that is playing very well offensively. We talked about how versatile they were offensively. They're going to win the ACC championship game over a very game North Carolina State team, and they're going to win the game in a situation where Vince Carter, one of their main offensive weapons, only scores 3 points. They have a lot of different guys who can hurt them.
How about this? Carolina is going to the Final Four in all the odd years of the 90s. 91, they lost to Kansas. 93, national champions. 95, lost to Arkansas. But they're going back this year to the NCAAs for the 22nd consecutive time, and they probably will go as a number one seed.
Wolfpack in the ACC Tournament Championship game.
Dan, what was interesting about that game is they turned their season around. They were down by 16, down by 9 with just a couple of minutes left. Came back and won it. And the scene at the Dean Dome that night was very similar to this. The fans came onto the floor. It looked as if they had won the tournament that night. And that was the resurgence of North Carolina.
Very, very impressive effort by the Tar Heels and a very game effort by North Carolina State. They had a number of open shots that they just didn't get to go in the basket. And if those shots go in, well, maybe it's a different game, but an outstanding job by North Carolina.
North Carolina wins the 1997 ACC Championship 64-54. Let's go over to Mike Hogwood.
Well, Jim, I'm here with Serge Wicker, who certainly made his height felt today. You knew this was a game where you could step in and take some advantage.
Definitely. I felt that, you know, we had a lot of height advantage, Antawn and me inside. We just took advantage of that, and, you know, great things happened.
All right, NC State. This is a team that you went down to the wire with twice in the season. You knew they may have been smaller than you, but they had a lot of fight today.
That's definitely true. NC State was always a good team. They were always ready to play against us. It was always a great matchup. And, you know, it showed again today.
0-3 to start the conference season. Now a probable number one seed in the NCAA. It's been quite a ride.
There's nothing better than that. You know, hopefully we'll get the number one seed and great things will happen for us.
Thanks a lot. All right. Serge Wicker, here comes Antawn Jamison. Antawn, great tournament. Congratulations on an ACC championship.
Oh, yeah. You know, it feels really good. You know, we started conference 0-3. You know, we turned things around. Now we won the tournament. You know, it feels really good right now.
What was the key to the win today over the Wolfpack?
We definitely just had to keep our composure, you know. We didn't want them to keep the game kind of close and try to pull it out at the end, but, you know, we did a terrific job. We know they can struggle from the outside. They like to penetrate, so we had to play excellent defense today.
What was the secret for this team? You mentioned 0-3. This team completely turned around. Right now, you're the hottest team in America. Now, as we said to Serge, a probable number one seed. What has been the secret?
Oh, we just stuck together, you know. After we started the season kind of poorly, you know, we just got together, put our egos aside, put everything aside, and said, hey, we know we're a very good team. We just got to come together. And now we're gelling. And like I said, we got the NCAA coming up. And we still got to keep, you know, our composure and just play basketball.
First half particularly, at the beginning of this game, you wanted that ball inside.
Yeah. You know, I wanted to ring so bad. You know, I wanted to win this game. Last year we lost in the opening round of the tournament. And, you know, that was a bad feeling. And tonight, I was going to put everything out here on the court. You know, I wasn't going to leave nothing out here. And, you know, we stuck together as a team. I did an excellent job on the boys. And, you know, we're happy right now.
Sir? Antawn, congratulations to you, ACC champions. That's Antawn Jamison, part of this ACC championship team.
Mike, thank you. 64-54 was the final. North Carolina wins its 24th game of the year. 24-6 is their record. And Dan, they finished with 12 straight wins.
They finished with 12 straight wins. They finished shooting the ball very well. They finished playing extremely well on the offensive end of the court, and I think that'll serve them very well in the NCAA tournament, which starts next week.
North Carolina, the ACC champion for 1997, will be back with more of the post-game festivities right after this message from Budweiser.
Advance Auto Parts presents part number 14, the brain. An active brain, like those found in Advance Auto Parts salespeople, is capable of analyzing any automotive problem.
I can't understand why I'm losing compression.
In a millisecond, the brain is working, computing options, calculating dimensions, until it comes up with the solution, allowing part number 12, the hand, to take over. Advance Auto Parts, the best part is our people.
Watch this. I'm going to balance my checkbook. No, really. This is worth watching. See, this is Nations Bank PC Banking. It lets you go online with Nations Bank to transfer money, pay all your bills, and balance your checkbook in a flash. Ready? Go. Click here, do that, and that, and done. Want to see that again?
We'll be right back. Basketball was brought to you by Food Lion, by Budweiser, by Nations Bank, by Pepsi, by Ford, and by Advance Auto Parts.
For the 14th time in ACC history, North Carolina claims the ACC Tournament Championship 64-54 over NC State in the first matchup between those two in the title game since 1987. North Carolina broke this game open in the second half. Shamon Williams scored the first 13 of North Carolina's 15 second-half points. He's standing by with our Mike Hogwood at courtside.
Yeah, Steve, and how about 20 points each of the last two games? Shamon, you really turned it on here in the last two games.
Well, yes, sir. I'm happy I was able to help my team in any given situation, be it scoring, be it passing the basketball, just playing defense. But it just wasn't myself. It was a whole team effort. We worked hard throughout the year, even though we were 0-3 at the beginning of the season, and a lot of things have turned around for us, and we're playing 110% now, and we're just happy with the way we're playing.
What's the difference in this team than when you started this league 0-3?
Well, we just basically know what to do in given situations. Coaches sat down with each and every individual and gave us a role to play, and each of us are doing that, doing what coach wants us to do. So we feel confident with the role we're playing. Even though we've been able to win a lot of games in the second half of the ACC season, we're confident, but we're not content. There's a lot of things that we need to work on, a lot of things we can do to get better, and there's always room for improvement. So hopefully we can continue doing those things, then maybe we can make a run in the NCAA tournament also.
Dan Bonner commenting during the game, you were feeling it out there. You really, with a hand in your face, you were going up and nailing some threes.
Well, yes, sir. I had the opportunity to get a lot of shots, even though they were playing me tough throughout the game. It just felt good to just knock in a few shots to help my team. Like I said before, it's a team effort. It's not just an individual thing. We're North Carolina, we're a team, and we represent a team, not an individual thing. And we're happy with this tournament championship. I think every individual on this team deserves it. And hopefully we can just continue throughout the NCAA tournament.
Shamon, you know what's happening now.
Yes, sir.
The Nets are coming down, and Shamon wants to be a part of it. Let's go back to Steve Martin.
Notice the big smile on Shamon Williams' face when Mike said, yeah, you had a hand in your face, and you took the jumpers and you hit them. And you see what's going on now. Strand by strand, that net will come down. The Greensboro Coliseum as the North Carolina Tar Heels celebrate their 14th ACC championship. Serge Swicker, such a big part of North Carolina's victory today, and their second-half surge that sees them still on a win streak, 12 straight, with a 10-point win over NC State in the title game.
Hey, guys, let's go back to the start. I don't know, it just sounds a little bit stiff.
Excuse me.
You ordered lunch?
It's lunchtime, isn't it?
Supper time, yeah. How's that transition?
Yeah, that works. Let me just change this to a pie chart.
I like the bar graph better.
No, pie.
Bar.
Pie.
Bar.
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 Pie.
Bar.
Bell South. It's all here.
I know a tip of the raid rat, bond with stab and punk metal. I'm on the level.
Next wave.
Generation, next generation.
No one gets the job done just like we do. The energy to do it right for you.
Many of the benefits working Americans enjoy today were originally obtained by unions through negotiated contracts. Unions like Atlanta IBEW Local 613.
Americans know how the IBEW.
Let's take a look at our MVPs for this game, and what a performance turned in by Justin Gainey. 160 minutes in this tournament. Every minute of every game, 11 points, 3 assists. All of his points came in the second half, and Shamon Williams, a second straight 20-point performance, 7 out of 12 from the field, 6 out of 6 from the foul line. Shamon Williams was very, very tough, especially in the second half. Let's get back down to the sidelines. Mike Hogwood with victorious Coach Dean Smith.
Coach Smith, another ACC championship, and it still gets exciting for you, these kind of victories.
It surely does, Mike, and I certainly feel for NC State because they had to play four games, and in many ways they deserve to win, but our kids did a great job, I thought, in this tournament, and I'm happy for them, and hope it carries over to next week.
What's the biggest improvement your team made from when they started the year 0-3 in the league and to now on this incredible winning streak?
Well, they got older, for one thing, experience, but shot selection was much better, and NC State really made us look bad, I thought, but that's their defense. I thought we played very well against Wake Forest and Virginia.
Now, perhaps the number one seed in the NCAA tournament. This team is ready, I think, for what they call March Madness.
I hope. We've done pretty well in March. I think beat Duke in the three games here, but know full well that anybody could do well in one game and you're out.
We made a big comment. The game you had Serge Zwicker, the tallest man on the floor, covering Justin Gainey, the smallest man on the floor.
They're hard to match up because I didn't want him on Benjamin. I didn't want him on Strong. And so life's full of trade-offs, isn't it?
It sure is. Coach Smith, congratulations again. Steve, back to you.
Well, thank you very much, Mike Hogwood. And the next ceremony is continuing. Serge Zwicker has cut it all down. And now we go on for the presentation of the tournament trophy. Well deserved by North Carolina. And what a run by NC State. Lasting four games, but they weren't able to conclude the deal because of that man and the North Carolina Tar Heels. It's a 10-point North Carolina win. We'll be back with more after this message from Budweiser.
That answers that question.
Part of life is not spent at a gas station. That's why everything we do, from our world-class fuels to BP credit cards, from pay at the pump to BP shops, we do to keep you moving.
We keep you moving. Moving. We keep you moving. Moving. We keep you moving. Moving. We keep you moving.
There's Shimon Williams, the emotion of the moment. They've accomplished a lot, and there's more yet to come for this young North Carolina team as the trophy celebration goes on. Individual awards being given now, and then the presentation of the 44th annual championship trophy. It'll have North Carolina's name on it for the 14th time as they denied NC State today, 64-54. You see assistant coach Phil Ford going out to get his award. He's been in this position before. And the roar goes up as Coach Dean Smith gets his individual award. And he's often called this team probably the most fun team he's had to coach. He's watched a young club overcome some injuries and uncertainty because of youth. This is a program that has lost some players in the early part of their career to the NBA, and he's had to readjust. That readjustment apparently is going along very nicely with their 12th straight win. The ACC Tournament Championship. It's picture time, then the trophy presentation. And let's point you back in the direction of the fellows who brought you this game. And Tim Branton and Dan, of course, we look at what happened in this contest. And we get to the 9:15 mark of this game where North Carolina State got to within three straight trips, three straight three-point attempts, three straight misses. Otherwise, this might have been a different verdict.
Yeah, Steve, I agree with you, and I think that fatigue could have been a factor there as far as the shooting with NC State, but
I think Jamison said it best when he said we just had to maintain our poise. North Carolina did, never did relinquish the lead. And as you look at the Carolina champions and Serge Wicker, who was a redshirt member of that national championship team in the early 90s at North Carolina. And here they are now going back to the NCAAs and probably will go in as a number one seed. And as they said, they're peaking.
Tim, and I think it's been, you've got to give Dean Smith a tremendous amount of credit for the adjustments that he made. Yes, the kids did get older, but I think that he had a team that was headed in the wrong direction, and one of his best skills as a coach is his ability to make adjustments, and he did make adjustments. I really think from seeing North Carolina early to seeing him now, that Dean Smith simplified things a little bit. They don't do as many things defensively as they did earlier in the year, certainly not as many things as past North Carolina teams have done.
I think he turned Carter loose.
Well, I think that's part of it. I think Vince Carter got healthy. Remember, he was hurt early in the year, and I think when you simplify things, then it's a little more comfortable for Ed Cota. I think Shamon Williams certainly came on and provided them with an outside threat, a consistent outside scoring threat, that you could no longer back in and cover Jamison. And then Serge Wicker emerged as well. So I think there's a lot of reasons for the North Carolina turnaround, but I think they all start with the head man. And I think he deserves an awful lot of credit.
I don't think there's any question about that. He picks up his 875th win. And of the 14 ACC championships won by North Carolina, 13 of those have come under the watchful eye of Dean Smith.
As they look and going into the NCAA tournament, Shamon Williams just named the tournament MVP. The all-tournament team, Tim Duncan from Wake Forest, joins Justin Ganey and CeCe Harrison of North Carolina State, and Antawn Jamison and Shamon Williams of North Carolina, and Shamon Williams winning the Everett Case Award as the tournament MVP.
Dan, you made a good point about Ed Cota and Williams being more comfortable. I think when Ed Cota went through that maturation process and gained that confidence, came into his own at midseason, and they were able to move Williams over to the two spot, take some of the ball handling pressures off of him, and he could then become what he is, just an outstanding shooter.
The other thing that Dean Smith did is he basically went with a seven-man rotation. And really, it's almost six men. The seventh guy would be Mactar Jai. Jai, for example, played 2 minutes today, and he has made valuable contributions coming off the bench, as you get a look at Mactar right there. But for the most part, Dean Smith settled on a particular rotation. You heard Shamon Williams talk about how they all understood their roles. Well, it's a whole lot easier to understand what your role is when you know when you're going in the game and when you're coming out of the game. And again, those are adjustments that come from the head guy.
All right, let's take you back now to Steve Barton.
Thank you very much, Tim and Dan. And the celebration continues here at Greensboro Coliseum as we gather down on the court. Still cutting the net at the other end of the court. And let's go to Mike Hogwood, who's standing by with Adamola Okalaja.
Thanks a lot, Steve. And Adi, you often don't get a lot of the praise, a lot of the glory, but you do a lot of the dirty work, something that's necessary on any championship team.
Well, yeah, I do. I want to win. And, you know, I do everything everything that's necessary to win. If it's a loose ball.
A cheer, by the way, for Coach Smith.
Oh, yeah.
Cutting down the net.
Best coach in the nation. You know, he's a great coach, you know, and he had to take a lot of nerve with us. Sometimes we're pretty nerve-wracking, especially in practice. But, you know, he's a great coach, you know, this is his award.
Coach Smith told me a moment ago that this is one of the most fun groups he's ever had a chance to work with, and I think that's a key to winning a championship, the fact that you guys all get along. You all seem to really be good friends off the court.
Yeah, we do a lot of things off court. First of all, we all live in one hall and in one dorm, and most of the team. So we see each other, you know, all day long, you know, in practice and off practice. And we do a lot, you know, watch movies, go out together, go to the mall, go to the movies, and, we, you know, go out to eat. So we're just a great team. You know, we love each other.
One of the keys in your mind to this team turning it around from an 0-3 record in the league to now conference champion.
Well, you know, we were practicing very well and very hard. And now, as we said earlier, we did not contribute or bring over what we did in practice to the game. And now now everybody sees our hard work that we did in practice is now on the court.
Adi, congratulations. Good luck in the NCAAs. Well, Steve, they often say that chemistry plays a big part in any team winning a championship. And I think it's pretty obvious from hearing these players that this is a team with great chemistry.
Well, you saw the look of pride on Coach Dean Smith's face just a few moments ago as he watched on as the net cutting ceremony continued. And it still continues. It's, you know, winning a championship can be tiring business. You think it's easy? Ask that, young man. North Carolina by 10. More from Greensboro coming up.
Ford Escort. Did you know that it's new? If you knew that it's new, did you know the wagon's new too? The engine is new, the suspension improved. A safety cell protects but stays out of view. It's quieter inside to shush out the out. But for those who simply must twist and shout, there's premium speakers on a new stereo, so you can get every note and get it to go. This Escort is great. This Escort is nice. This Escort has a very sensible price. So why not check out the newest Escort this season? We've given you every rhyme and rhymed every reason.
Welcome back, North Carolina. 64-54 winners over NC State in the ACC Championship here in Greensboro. Let's take a look at our Earl All-Tourney first team. No surprises here. You know, it seems like a week since Tim Duncan has played, but it was just last night or yesterday afternoon, and he leads the way on the ACC All-Tourney first team. Antawn Jamison, joined by Shamon Williams, who's the tourney MVP. Justin Gainey, the freshman from High Point. And C.C. Harrison, who had an outstanding tournament, although he was shut down to only 3 points in the second half of this game. They say that point guard is the most difficult position to play, especially when you're a freshman point guard. There's another freshman point guard who had a great ACC tournament. He's standing by with Mike Hogwood right now, who's got Ed Cohn.
Maybe the most improved North Carolina Tar Heel over the past couple of months. Ed Cohn, your comments, your thoughts now about it, your championship and your freshman year.
Well, I think the first half of the ACC season was a learning experience for me, and second half, my teammates had a lot of confidence in me, and I don't think it's really a one-man team or nothing like that. I think it was a team effort, and everybody just got involved, and we playing together as a unit, and I think that's the biggest difference.
What does having a guy like Phil Ford coach you every day in practice? What does that mean to you?
Oh, that's great, because he's been here before. He played under Coach Smith for 4 years, and That's a plus for me, because McGinnis went pro and I ain't have nobody else to really learn from. So it's just great having him around to lead me.
You also seem to have found your shot a little bit, and particularly the three here in this tournament. You hadn't made one since December, and you come here to the ACC tournament and nail two of them.
Well, I felt comfortable taking the shots. They left me wide open, so I just decided to take them, and they just went down.
Congratulations. That plaque looks awful nice, doesn't it?
Thanks a lot, sir.
All right, good luck in the NCAA tournament. North Carolina's freshman point guard, Ed Cohn. Steve?
Thank you very much, Mike Hogwood. And here are your final stats. Look at North Carolina from the field. 23 of 39 from the field. And the free throw line is where they put it away at the end, 15 out of 20. NC State only getting 5 trips to the line on this afternoon. And they shot only 33%, or just under that, from the field. 3-point field goals, 32 attempts by NC State. They only were able to hit 10. North Carolina, 3 out of 8, all from the hand of Shamon Williams. The rebounding edge heavily in favor of North Carolina, and well, it should be because of their superior height underneath. The turnovers, though, NC State got in the ball game by forcing 18 North Carolina turnovers, several of them critical steals near the end. Points off turnover, 18-7 in NC State's favor, but the score in favor of North Carolina, 64-54 in the ACC Championship. We'll be back after these words from your local ACC station.
Introducing the 1997 Miller Lite Stock Car. Sure beats other sedans. The new Miller Lite Indy Car. No radio, no heat, but hey, look at that handling. And if it's acceleration you're after, take a look at the Miller Lite Top Fuel Dragster. It leaves everything else at the light. Every Miller Lite car comes with our 16-second roadside assistance plan. We say, shoot, shop, and compare.
What's that little gizmo you have there?
This? Well, I can actually enter patients' vital signs in here, and I can transfer them anywhere, even right to a doctor's desk.
Fancy. So Columbia's cutting out charts and paper. Smart?
Yeah.
But can I see? So, you know, I saw a movie once where they transported a guy through thin air with something like this.
Okay.
Oh. I'm not trying to one-up you or anything.
For the nearest Columbia facility, call 1-800-COLUMBIA.
Listen,
This is what investing can be. When investment fads, hot stock tips, and pushy sales calls are put aside, and a relationship has begun. At SunTrust, our investment professionals focus only on investments. They start by listening and learning, not selling. They finish by recommending solutions. And maybe
Ultimate Deep Dish. All made to order and delivered hot and fresh right to your front door. Domino's three delicious crusts.
Domino's!
Hot! Wow! Now!
Get a free medium one-topping pizza when you buy any large two or more topping pizza at regular menu price. Buy a large and just ask for your free one-topping medium pizza at Domino's now.
Welcome back to the Greensboro Coliseum as the fans file out into a sunny Sunday afternoon, comforted by the fact that North Carolina has beaten NC State in the ACC Championship by a score of 64-54. It's their 14th ACC title for NC State. It was a great run, four games, and, well, it just didn't come up. And it looks like, though, that North Carolina State will get the NIT bid that they had hoped for coming into the tournament. And for a moment, they thought NCAA. But that process starts later on this afternoon. Hold up in a hotel in Kansas City, the NCAA Division I Basketball Committee. Their thoughts going into the process of selecting 64 teams to go into this tournament. With North Carolina's win here, it looks like they'll probably be a number one seed. As we go back to Tim Brandt and Dan Bonner, fellas, we thought that there would be six ACC teams in that field. Do you fellas both share the thought that that will be the case when the tournament field is decided today?
I don't think there's any question about it. Had NC State won this game, I think that seven would have gone and Virginia still would have been in, but I definitely think six will. You mentioned the nine-member committee out there chaired by Terry Holland of the University of Virginia. I think they're well aware of the fact that North Carolina is making its 23rd consecutive trip to the NCAAs and probably will get a number one seed and play right here in North Carolina.
Tim, I think the most significant thing about North Carolina's seeding is the fact, with as strong as the ACC has been all year, it's generally been accepted that the ACC champion would get a number one seed. Now, I think we can take it as a matter of fact that Clemson, Duke, Maryland, obviously North Carolina has the automatic bid, and Wake Forest will get an invitation to the tournament. The problem, I think, still remains with the University of Virginia. Everybody around the ACC, myself included, feel that the University of Virginia certainly deserves a bid to the tournament. One of the tools that the NCAA committee uses is the RPI, and what that is a power rating, basically, that tries to rank the teams according to strength of schedule and other variables, and Virginia has been in the top 25 of that rating all year long. Currently, they're number 25. According to that schedule, they've played the sixth toughest schedule in the country. When you look at Virginia's non-conference losses, they have two. One was to Connecticut in overtime. The other one was to the University of Kansas. The rest of their losses all coming in the ACC.
The committee also looks at your record, how you finished the season, as Dan mentioned, the strength of your schedule, and all that, I think, works in the favor of Virginia. They got a quality win against Maryland to end the season.
But the thing you have to point out is Virginia is one of those teams, Tim, who I think, depending upon the way these various conference tournaments work out, Virginia is in a situation where they might still not get a bid. People around the ACC would think that's unfair, but every year you have a couple of teams who feel they should get in the tournament who don't. I think for the Virginia Cavaliers, they're going to be sweating it a little bit. But, of course, this is what everybody's been talking about. You know, for the last month, we've been talking about teams on the bubble, who's going to get into the tournament, and now's the time for the ACC